smileys out there. Good gosh, you people are smiley. Call us the aggressive smile era. Whoa. Anyway, today I went to like a public governmental building, and I stood in line and I did some of those paperworky things. And yet, when I was there, I was standing in the line, and I get there to the person. They're like really almost, oh boy, did they turn their smiley off. They're just like, you look different than what I want here in this town. It was that, like, I'm gonna give you trouble maybe. Know if you have the right paper. I'm gonna have to really read what you have because I don't trust you. Wow. I mean, I know my face is like, you know, the white reddish complexion of what the Scots that should never have left the Highlands. But, oh my gosh. And then he went, and then he went over to his mommy of the next teller lady and did something with the paperwork and got some confirmation, you know. But I really did feel like she was gonna give like next to, you know, we don't like her. We're gonna be racists against her. And I'm like, oh my gosh, I don't look Hispanic enough. What am I gonna do? You know, I kind of live in this town. They didn't want me there. Didn't want me there. Anyway, in the excitement of the day, I did have my high heels on, and that kind of makes me happy. So I did have my high heels that took me back to the vehicle. And yeah. How rude. You know, you can say, oh, it's a public place, they're not allowed to, they have to treat everybody the same. Oh, they don't. They do not. Racism is alive and well here where I live in this town. Especially if you look like you are from the Scottish Highlands. I don't like you. Just a tedious upset, you know, a tedious upset into their daily Hispanic ritual. Like I've upset the Pancho Villa war, you know, it's supposed to be going on still. I've upset it somehow by being here. How can they take over when another white face is standing in front of them? They adore Pancho Villa here. They adore the stories of the madman who was originally supported by the Mexican government, given money and funds to be a bandito, and then he turned on the Mexican government and turned on the United States, and yet he's still accoladed as some king here. So yeah, each white face in this little village, I would call it, because that's the way they are acting. It's provincial, like a village. This little tiny village is really running street with that bastard. They want that Pancho Villa. They want the takeover on the United States soil, Hispanica. They don't want my white face. Yeah, it was almost like he was going to deny my paper. And I was looking for a reason, looking for a call. I'm going to deny it. Anyway, so that's it. That's my story for the day, everybody. Look at these strong muscles. What else have I done? Oh my gosh, I am starting to do the ballet. Not really. I'm starting another bunch of what do we call it? We call it the art with the photographs, the images. I'm doing those again. I do a lot of photo art, like graphic photo art, you know, all that tricking. So I'm doing that for my next book, because that's what I am at the moment. It's the book lady. Poetry book lady. And I'm watching ballets, since everybody wants to know what people do all day. I watch ballets and watch some good new ones, and some that I'm not so hyped on. I see a lot of amazing bodies out there that are in pointe shoes, but it doesn't mean they can dance. I did see a very wonderful exercise today through one of the teachers, a major teacher. I won't call her major. She's not yet major, but she might be someday. Even, you know, more well-known, but she definitely has a really nice little exercise, and she took it from the Royal, because it's World Ballet Day and all of that. She took it from the Royal. It's just a regular fondue en face, and then a plié on the standing leg, and then ronde de jambe that to the side. Very gorgeous moment, and then again, plié, fondue, alisacon, and then a plié on that standing leg, and ronde to arabesque. It's just gorgeous. I love that style. It is something that is so pure, and it gets you here, you know, in your muscles here, your standing leg muscles. It gets these muscles, so you don't have to be a stupid idiot and go to the gym to be a ballet dancer. It gets these muscles, you see. So you never have to do that stupidity that they keep pushing. You know, so you get dancers that are too muscly, like, oh, I'm dancing. You know, this never that, you know. You're never supposed to be this stress case scenario. But that's what they're doing, you know. You have to do so many of this and so many of that. And anyway, so that exercise, it does plenty, and it does enough. So, yeah, beautiful fondue. Anyway, it did have a balance one through and then into passe. But anyways, that's my day. A little racism epic. Yeah, it's tough to not take it personally.